Today's video is inspired by Arif the designer. Shout out to Arif. Arif, we loved your logo that you did on Pixalab and we decided we're going to create it on Photopea. By the way, stick with me until we convert this logo so that you can learn how to download it as a quality design. Let's create this nature 3D logo using Photopea. Select new project. And you're going to pick your canvas and the sizing. If you want to convert it to 3D, you're going to make it transparent. And then you click on create. Then you're going to go to your tools and you're going to pick a shape. We're going to use the ellipse tool. And you're going to choose a color. Because we're creating a leaf, we're going to make it nice and green. And then we start click and you drag and you hold. And you create the shape of a leaf-like. Next, you're going to pick your curvature pen to create the pointiness of a leaf. So you're going to click on the top of the leaf and start making it pointy like that. Next, you're going to go back to your tools and we want a line this time. We pick a line and we draw a line. We're going to make it nice and thin. We can make it whatever color we want. I'm going to just change it to white and pick the move tool or press V to move it over to our shape like that. And then you're going to go to your layers and click on combine shapes and subtract. That way, when you click on the move tool, there's that little gap of a leaf that you've created. Beautiful, happiness. Now you're going to rasterize the shape because we want to make it a little bit smaller. So we're going to go to shapes and we click on rasterize. Then we select transform control. Then we can make it smaller shape. I'm going to pick my move tool with a V and I can move it to the other side of my page. I'm going to duplicate into 4 and create my leaves. Great stuff. I'm going to go back to my shapes and I'm going to select my ellipse shape and I'm going to create a circle. I want this circle to also be green and I'm happy with that. I'm gonna just switch off the transform control. Okay, cool. Now we're gonna go back to our ellipses and change color so we see what we're doing. You don't have to. And create a second shape. You know, when you are holding your arrow up, it creates a perfect circle. If you are using a Windows, then you can use shift. Move and you align them to create that beautiful C-like shape and you add them like that. Then you're going to go to your layer and combine shapes and subtract. And we're happy with that shape. We go back to ellipses and we create the second shape. Like that. Then we go on our design spree. We use our leaves. I think they're a little bit big, so I'm gonna make them smaller. Cool, then we're gonna use our move tool to start the design process of our leaves. We're gonna rotate it and start placing it on the C shape line. And there you go. So the last thing you're gonna do is to add text. You're going to click on your type tool and select type tool. And we're going to make the color of our text also green. And we're going to use Anton as the font for this one. So we're going to search for Anton and we're going to size it. Maybe make it 70 or 60. Let's see how big that is. And then you start typing the name of the nature or the company. That's a little bit small. So you're going to highlight it. And you're going to go to your sizing and make it big. So 150 looks like it's perfect. I'm going to select my move tool, move it just in the middle of that design. Then I'm going to go back to my shapes, pick a line and create a golden line, an underline, and a T like that. And then last thing, we're going to go back to our type tool and change to Bilbo Swash Caps and type the rest of the name of the business. So we want that to be the same color as our line. We just align everything. And there you go. There's your 2D gorgeous nature logo. Thank you, Arif. We love it. We're now going to convert it to 3D. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to duplicate this tab and have a second Photopea tab. So you're going to download this as an SVG. So you're going to go file and you're going to export it as a SVG. SVG downloads it as a web file, but it makes it look good and the quality is just the best. So you're going to make sure that you've ticked add rasterize graphics. We don't have any hidden layers that we want to include. We want to vectorize the text. We want to rasterize the text as well. And we're going to click on save. And then it saves it with a browser file, as you see. So we're going to jump back to our second Photopea tab and we're going to pick a template on this one. And we're going to go to our mockups. I just wanted to use this one today. It's called Logo Mockups on Black Textile. Then you're going to double click and open it up and click on the link to open the mockup itself. You're going to double click where it says your logo here and you're going to hide your graphics text. You click and you drag the file that you just downloaded and look at that. It's beautiful. It is transparent. This is what I missed for so long. Anyway, we found it. It's gorgeous. You're then sizing it. And you're going to press Command S or Control S to convert it to Smart Object. And you're going to click back on the first tab. And the quality, oh my word, it is just out of this world. The difference between SVG looks like this and the PNG looks like this. All pixelated and ugly. I've switched on a Design with Zaa membership on YouTube. So if you want to be part of our designs and you want to get a little bit of perks and designs before everybody else, please join our membership. If you do enjoy these tutorials, go watch this next video that we've created on Photopea. I can't wait to see you on the next video. Thank you so much for spending quality time with me. I will see you on the next video.